Well, first of all, fantasy football is a lifestyle. But on the basic level, basically what fantasy football is it's a collection of NFL players that you compile on your team. And their real life statistics are weighed onto whether you win or lose. So whoever is the smartest and knows the most about sports wins, and best looking. That's why I won last year. And you pick players, and how they do in their games reflects how many points you get. Favorite thing about fantasy football is, of course, winning, because I do it a lot. I thoroughly enjoy beating my friends, lowering their self-esteem. It's fabulous. I know much more about sports than they do, and it's shown by my fantasy football record. I am the defending champion, and I'm looking for a second title this year. Off to a rough start, but I'm on my way. I'm gonna make a run.
There's no one that you like to beat more in this league than Zachary Dill, just because he's such a horrible person. He's just like, he's a piece of shit. So when it comes to that, on that season, on our first season, when I was last place and I won the Toilet Bowl trophy, actually this was last season, I also managed to beat him both the times that I played him. And so, you know, that's the one good thing about my season, even though everything else was bad. Yeah.
My favorite thing about fantasy football is winning, because I'm the best there is. That's all I have to say.
Favorite thing about fantasy football was winning the league 2 years ago. My first year playing, the first year of the league.
F*** you, Zach! You're gonna f*** me before! I didn't play to where and half the f***! Presented by the all-new...
Zach is hung like a monkey.
My best fantasy football memory was probably right on that porch when our good friend Drew Bethard cried real tears.
Drew Bethard crying real tears multiple times.
Why'd you cry real tears?
What?
I'm talking about my best moment. Why'd you cry real tears? When my good friend Drew, he was hurting for a win. He needed it to make the playoffs, which he didn't end up doing, considering he's never made the playoffs. It's a trend. He was hurting for a win. It was at the end of the year last year, crunch time. His running back, Doug Martin, fumbled the ball on the 2-inch line, probably costing him a win, possibly a playoff spot. And he cried real tears. Tears streamed down his eyes, he stormed out of the house, just ran away. It was priceless. The second best moment, I'd say, is similar, but instead of, you know, sadness, it was rage. When our good friend Ben Thurman kicked through his windshield.
My best memory? I wasn't around for this, but hearing about Ben Thurman kicking down a car window, it's pretty funny.
And fantasy football rage. I mean, it really gets me when fantasy football brings out emotion in the form of real tears and broken windshields.
What made him do that?
I don't know.
Up the middle, bouncing out.
Damn it!
Let's see. I started playing fantasy football league to tear shit up. First of all, you're with some of your good friends, and It's funny watching some of your friends just get destroyed week by week. That's the reason why I joined.
No! You f***ing idiot, DeMarco!
The Bears recovered in the end zone. And Hopkins runs on right arm of his.
Oh, that's DeMarco.
And the Bears are going to come up with a turnover that will automatically be reviewed as
I've had a bad career, and I mean, I have a couple of souvenirs from it. So we got these four trophies that go around each year. There's going to be the crybaby trophy, kind of for, I mean, it says right here, to the manager that constantly complained as his team plummeted down the standings. There's also the toilet bowl trophy, and that goes to the person that loses the last place game. And there's also, don't forget this last one, the worst manager award. For the manager who, by completing awful trades and constantly making mistakes on the waiver wire, led their team to ultimate destruction. And this is from. Okay, so this is our. Stop. This is our league's third season in the running, and I have been by far the most unsuccessful manager in the league. Although this year I think I'm going to make a comeback, but. So 2 years in a row it's been me. Last place, not making the playoffs. And it's been eight teams. Six of them make the playoffs, and 2 years in a row I haven't made the playoffs, so it's pretty horrible.
There he is! No! Come on! Fuck you! Yes! 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 Draymond's back!
Fuck you!
Draymond's back!
Before I started fantasy football, I thought it'd be like, it seemed really cool. I didn't really care that much because I cared more, a lot more about college football. But, and I thought it would be really time consuming. You wouldn't be able to do your homework, but now I'm in it. It's the shit. You get to do a lot of awesome stuff.
Like before, I think people play just because it's a way to, it's a great way to like bond over something. It's still a competition. It's really fun, and you can just get into the game of football without having a favorite team or anything. You can really get into the NFL. I like that about it.
Well, everyone in the league's really into football and basketball, and it just makes the games more interesting to watch and makes everything more competitive, and I win a lot, so.
And why do you think it's so popular in America?
Just because everyone can be involved with it. You know, everyone's, you know, they're more involved with it personally. They're making the calls on who to play and trades and stuff. It gets interesting.
Fantasy football to me is a way of life. It's a religion.
Mother! Sucks!
All right! Over by the water cooler, listen to the chatter. Well, I'm working to get fired, but it doesn't seem to matter when the